Hi, this is Jacob with PCTechGuide.com, and in this video series, we're covering how to speed up your slow computer, and this is the actual first hands-on video. The other video just explained several reasons of why your computer could be slow, and in this video, we're going to help by addressing one particular issue, and that is called virtual memory. Now, the amount of memory you have installed in your computer is called RAM, and that's random access memory, and it's that memory that actually holds your programs as they're currently open, and depending upon how much memory you have there, that can severely slow your computer down. So we'll go ahead and take a look. So I'm going to hit the Windows Start button, and we do have our video link in the channel, our channel link in the description below, and is what that's going to do is it's going to link to the actual YouTube channel for our slow computer series, and you can go through all these videos, and you know, if you go through five or six of the videos, then definitely you're going to end up with a faster computer. You know, it's just this one issue might not be your issue. So I'm going to go ahead and right click on computer. I'm going to go to properties, and here we're going to see that I have a Windows 7 computer here with an i7 processor, Intel, and 6 gigs of RAM. So if you need more memory, this part would cost you money if you were actually go out and purchase more memory for your system. And if you're unsure, you can go ahead and look at the model number on your computer and go to the manufacturer's website, or you can use type in any search engine memory configurator and punch in your model number, and it'll tell you how many slots your computer has for memory, and how much memory it's capable of holding, as well as recommending memory for you. And you might be surprised at the low cost that, you know, I had 12 gigs in here, but one of the sticks actually died on me, and I have mine's in a channel segment. So basically I had to remove three memory sticks because they were no longer working. But still, even at 6 gig, my computer's still going really, really good. So, you know, it has to do with the processor, it has to do with memory, it has to do with access in the hard drive. But in this particular thing, we're going to look at another instance besides just RAM. That's the biggest tip I can give you, because RAM's super cheap out there nowadays, and that is your virtual memory. So I'm going to go under the advanced system settings right here, and then we're going to make sure we're under the advanced tab, then go over to settings, and what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at the virtual memory. So I'm over here, I'm going to go to the advanced tab one more time, and under the advanced tab right here it says top page file size for all drives 6133 megabytes. I'm going to go ahead and hit change. And if we look here, you're going to see that I already did a custom size. So by default, yours is probably looking something like this. It's going to be automatic, and the currently allocated would be whatever it is there, right? So it'll be there, and then it'll give the recommended amount. So if you uncheck this, you can go ahead and put in the recommended amount as the minimum. So I'll do 9199 as my initial size, and then the maximum size. Right here, you're going to see the space available on your drive that you can actually put in. You can put in pretty much really that whole space. Now, I wouldn't do it all. I do maybe half. This is a smaller drive that I have on the C drive. So, you know, just depend upon how much space I want to use for that. And by increasing this size, is what it's going to do is you're going to be able to open up more programs and have more things in active memory. And it's just going to help, especially if you're, let's say, watching Netflix, right? And you're watching Netflix in your web browser, and you know the video keeps pausing on you, kind of, but the audio you can still hear, and then all of a sudden it catches and it speeds up a little bit later. Well, that's probably because you don't have enough memory on your system to handle it, or the computer's really hot. So there could be multiple issues there going on, but oftentimes if you increase the virtual memory, you're going to find that it's going to give you a nice little boost to your computer. So to figure it out, like I said, you know, you can go ahead and go with the recommended amount. Another tip that you can do here is I'm going to bring up the system calculator real quick. And I have 6 gigs installed on my computer. So I'm going to go 6 times, and 1 gig is actually 1024. So 6 times 1024, because that's the blocks that we're doing it in, equals. So this would be the minimum I would set it to is 6144. And let me go ahead and I'm going to times that by 2. And so I have 12, or 12288, and that's what you'll see I actually ended up putting as the max. And that is going to be under what the space available is here. So that's generally my rule of thumb, is just times it by 2. So again, that's going to be 1024 times the number represented by the installed RAM. So if it was 2, you times it by 2. If it was 4, times it by 4. In my case, I'm timesing it by 6. And I am simply doubling it again, so times 2. And so that's the number that you can enter in there. And this should give you a nice boost. Now, will it give everybody a boost? No. If this isn't your issue, then you're not going to get the system performance that you're looking for. But in the following videos, one of them will probably be partially what's happening to you, and it all adds up. You know, this might give you a 3% boost that you might not notice, but doing it a few times and doing a few of the other tweaks is definitely going to help you out. Now, once you do make that change, you do have to restart your computer. You'll be prompted to restart it. Feel free and just say, hey, restart later, and continue on with the videos in this in the link below in the description for the video channel, because you're going to want to go through multiple videos and really integrate more of the tips. They're not hard to do, and everything we show you is pretty much free. That's it. Thanks for watching. Feel free, like, share, comment. It all helps to move this video up in the rankings, and that's what I'm looking for. Thanks. Appreciate it.